Welcome, everybody. To the Adrift. We're streaming some more Persona 2 tonight for JRPG July. The intro run here for a second. Just to make sure that I am showing up as online. Second, just dealing with these issues. Okay, excellent. Welcome to the chat. Hello, Cass. Welcome, welcome. Just making sure everything is in order here. All right, as some of you may know, some of you have been in chat before, we're playing Persona 2. We're doing this for JRPG July, which is a fun little activity. Bunch of people playing JRPGs, whether on stream or on their own, during the month of July. No idea if we're going to finish this game this month, but we're making progress. We're about, I'd say, 5, almost 6 hours in by this point. Streamed it twice before. And, we're making progress. We're making progress. Hello, Cass. Hi. What I'd like to do is make you a mod. I'm not sure how to do that. Ah, here we go. Mod user. Please. Cannot do that. Okay, excellent. So you should be a mod now, which means that you should be able to add links and things. So that's cool. All right. And I am showing up online. Very good. But fantastic. All right. So let's get started. Last time we were still in the high school. We'd made it up to the fourth floor after getting our ass handed to us by a squirrel girl and some other critters, things like that. And what I believe is about to happen is we're about to hit a boss fight. Now, I don't know if this is going to kick us out of the dungeon once we've completed the boss fight, or whether we're going to leave the normal way. I don't think any of the enemies we've encountered here are unique, so we should be able to get contracts with them later, but I have no idea. This is my first full playthrough of the game. I've only tried snippets of it before. Anyone who's just joining us or watching the VOD for the first time, we are Maya Amano. We are a journalist. We're here with our friend Ulala, investigating a series of grisly murders in a high school. We've received a note from the killer telling us we're next. The principal of the high school has been murdered. We've met some of the students, one of whom has been in an accident which meant the end of her career as a track athlete. And so the principal suspected her of being the killer or hiring the killer. We've also met the killer, who is a man wearing a paper bag with a face painted on it, who's completely can't take him seriously at all. However, he seems to be able to summon demons, so that's a thing. And in fact, awakened some powers in us, which allow us to summon demons and do magic. And so, since that point, we've been trapped in this high school, fighting off monsters and talking to them, trying to form contracts with them to get them to do stuff for us or give us items. So, we are going to go ahead and head up these stairs here and see what fate awaits us. Let me just check how we're doing here. We're in pretty good shape health-wise. I don't think there's a lot for us to worry about here. If need be, we'll have Maya heal Ulala before the battle begins. Or right at the start. I suppose we could just do it now. Let's see. That'll use 3 MP. Maybe worth using. Probably not. Most of the enemies that we've encountered have done about 13 damage or so. So we've got at least 2 hits in us. On one character. I think we're probably fine. So let's go ahead and I'm just going to check one more thing. Okay, and there's the fourth floor, which is how we get to the clock tower. There's our health. Well, we're not going to worry about that. Let's go up to the fourth floor. Let the cards fall as they may. Alright, now we've got some spooky heartbeat music going on here. We should perhaps be a little concerned. Well, up we go. Okay, here we go. We've got some sort of battle going on. I wonder if this is the boss battle or...
Don't underestimate me, you bastard!
Oh, okay. All right. These are folks that we've already talked to. Haha, dealing with the cat. That's all right. Kitty wrangling is a full-time occupation. No worries. Welcome back to the chat. Yeah, kitties are, you know, they have priority. Let's see if we can get out of this battle without taking any damage. We'll talk to someone we already have a contract with. Let's see. Oh. All right. All right, we'll do that one more time. That should, All right. Ghost is going to ask us some questions. Hey, I've been curious for some time now. Humans sometimes put a banana thing to their ears and talk to themselves. What the heck are they doing? I think when we said talking to people far away, they were disappointed. Summoning the Great Joker will make them sad, probably, or scared. Let's try their mumbling to themselves. Oh, no, they didn't like that. Alright, we got out of that fine. The ghost is going to give us some tarot cards and leave us alone. So we got out of that without taking any more damage, which is good. Save here right outside the boss door. I have a feeling there's going to be a cutscene or something here. So what do we think? Are we gonna be meeting up with the Great Joker here? I think we will. I think that's what's up next. So, we used our clock tower key. In we go. Now this is quite unusual, I think, for a high school to have a giant menacing clock tower like something out of The Great Mouse Detective. In it. I don't know. Maybe all Japanese high schools are like this, but I think this is stylized just a bit. Ulala says, "Ah, there, over there." Oh. All right, so this is Joker talking to Anna, who is the high schooler that was injured. That's interesting. I like the way they gave her sprite a little bit of a limp there. So Joker says, "Lady, you are my partner. I am here for you." Anna says, "I don't even know you. I never did the Joker curse." Joker says, "No need to worry. You'll understand me and the other side." This is the second time the Joker has talked about the other side. We've met a bunch of people who seem to recognize us, and we seem to recognize them without any memory of who they are. There's definitely something going on here. I still can't get over how this guy's shtick is just he has a paper bag over his head. Like, come on, dude. You can have a better disguise than that. Alright. Pointing menacingly. "If you do, you'll realize that this side is the evil side. I won't hurt you. Let's go." She doesn't like that. I wouldn't like
Number
that either.
501, get away from that girl.
Okay, we've got voice acting here. Voice acting alert.
Don't get in my way! You can just play with this!
Suddenly we're in a mid-90s Eurotech club. You're in the twilight zone. It's gonna shake your bones. In the twilight zone. Anyway. Sorry, folks. Okay. He brought his lunch in it. That's probably why it's got all these terrible stains on it. Just some horrible mess of leaking sauce. I bet the inside of it reeks. Alright. What are these guys? Empu sauce? A pep. Okay. Now, I'm not Egyptian, but wasn't Apep like the big guy? Like the chaos serpent that was going to end the world? And here we've just got ads. They're just ads. They're just mobs. How the mighty have fallen. Alright, they're both level 3. He's level 4. I know nothing about them. I'm actually really digging this soundtrack. This is nice. Alright. I'm betting we can't contact any of these folks because it's a boss battle. Think before you act. Do they all say something? She says, "Don't get friendly with me." Interesting. Alright. This is letting us know that we can't cheese our way out of this one. Alright, let's strategize. I think maybe our strongest opening is to do a fusion spell, which requires us to do water and then fire and then earth. Okay, cool. So that actually sets that up for us. We'll take it in single turns so we don't run into some sort of auto awfulness. Oh, excuse me. Terribly sorry. Right. Let's see what happens. Hit it.
What?
Oh, that's not good. Yeah, we're gonna hit go on this. Go. Let's go ahead and target our big bad here. As long as the little guys don't heal her, it should be fine. Okay, that was pretty rad. Got her. Okay, that was rad. Alright. Okay, Ulala is not looking great here. Those guys are hitting us for 10. And there's two of them. If they gang up on her, she's toast. So, let us... let us heal. Well, what are you gonna use here? We're gonna use Zan on this Apep and Katsuya. Oh, cool! You learned a third spell. That's awesome. That must have happened this battle because I don't think he had it last time. So that's cool to know. When our personas rank up, we get their spells automatically. So that's great. All right, let's hit it. Single shot. Concentrated fire. Hit it. Not bad.
It's over.
13. Okay, not as good. These guys have quite a bit of health. Do we know anything more about these yet? Huge snake that lives in the Nile River, Ra's enemy. Yes, could have told you that. Right. Hello, Morphine24. Welcome to the chat. You missed some top-notch voice acting just a minute ago. We are now in the middle of the clock tower from the Great Mouse Detective, fighting a couple of ancient Egyptian gods who are following the orders of a man with a paper bag for a face. Meanwhile, 90s anthem Twilight Zone is playing in the background. Pretty pumping, pretty awesome. So let's hit this here. So Zan did decently. Ulala can only take two more hits here. If we shift our order around. Let's try another combo spell. And let's battle. Yes. We're gonna head into battle here, and we're gonna fight this, actually, this guy we've already hit a few times. This guy we haven't hit at all. let's try this out. Let's see if we can get this guy in one hit like we did the boss. Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. So we've hit this guy twice already. If we just gang up and attack, that should be fine to get rid of him. Let's go!
I'll shoot!
Okay, that's maybe a little too close for comfort.
Yeah.
Okay, so physical attacks, not good. Not good. Alright. Oodala, you are going to... I'm going to use Xan again. That seemed pretty strong. Pretty strong, Maya. Yeah, Ulala here. Kitsuya! You're gonna Ahi him. And let's change the order up. Make sure that Ulala can survive this battle. This is pretty desperate here. Alright. Go. Fantastic.
Persona.
What? Still not dead. What the heck? All right. No, didn't mean to do that. Wasted a turn. That is one thing that I will knock this game for. The separating the command for just battling from actually choosing what you're going to do next, it probably saves time if you have like some sort of kick butt strategy that just wipes the floor with everybody, but when you're just sorting things out and you need to change stuff up from turn to turn, it makes it take twice as long. But I guess if you're buff and you're just running around grinding, it can be advantageous to have a set strategy and just hit battle. But yeah. Okay, we got some level ups. Level up. Agility, we've already got decent agility compared with other folks. I think we're gonna pump tech. That pushes our SP up to a decent level. And gives us good. Hello, Golden Spider, and welcome to the chat. I'm Cameron, I'm the Adrift. Say hi, everybody. We're playing Persona 2. We just beat a boss fight with a couple of Egyptian gods and somebody I don't recognize who were summoned by some dude in a paper bag in a clock tower in a high school who is mouthing off about something about the other side. So we're gonna find out just how deep this rabbit hole goes as soon as I figure out what stats to buff. We got some advice last time, that, tech is... What difficulty is this on? I think it's just normal. I usually play through games normal. I don't remember if I actually got a choice about difficulty when I started. This is pretty much a blind playthrough, so I'm just playing it normal for now. I think this time we're also going to buff our, Morphine 24. That seems to be what I crawl. I don't remember getting a choice at the beginning of the game. Oh, gosh. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put two into tech. And we'll put... we'll put one into... I mean, her strength is kind of irrelevant because she's got a couple of pea shooters. and one more point of tech is not gonna... Yeah, we're gonna do two into tech, maybe one into agility. Just so we can be on top of things. Yes, this is okay. Ooh la la. Now, is this right? Am I not supposed to be able to adjust the other characters individually? They just have an automatic thing. It seems to be, because it's not giving me any adjustments here at all. So I guess they have their own skill trees. So Katsuya is shaping up to be our heavy hitter, which is odd, considering that Ulala is kind of, at least in character, she's sort of our tank. Like, she's a boxer, she's a... Golden Spider, you like to try to balance all the stats except luck. I'm usually that way. Like, in most games, I like things nice and symmetrical, but I'm also hella indecisive. But I have it on good authority that Shin Megami Tensei games are games where you just pump magic for all you got and wipe the floor with everybody. Alright, so here's our Joker, who says, not bad. Oh, fine, just sleep for a bit. Yeah, I'm not sure what luck does, except give us rare drops and stuff. I'm not much of a speedrunner or a luck runner, so that's kind of whatever for me. I'm also deliberately not being a completionist on this, because I usually am, and that could take forever. so we're just gonna run with we're gonna pretty much ignore luck. Persona Pixie on rank 8 gives you 99 luck. That's good to know, Morphine. Now, Morphine 24, do you know if we can, like, go... If we can stay in this dungeon and try and collect these enemies after the boss battle here is done? Or do we get just ejected out? Like, are there any bad guys... Are there any demons here that we can't find anywhere else? Joker says, oh fine, just sleep for a bit. So Anna has fainted, which is not good. He's probably going to do something we won't like. Oh, okay, alright, there's his persona guy. And we're all going to go to sleep, it looks like. Yep. There we go. Good night. A flight of angels sing thee to thy rest. Joker, you're... Sword fighting? Aw, man. We should have specced into fighter. Gotten some sweet swords. Sweet katana. I was right, this is the Deja Vu boy. This is the guy we met in our opening cutscene, who's not the main character. The game pulls a nice little troll on us that way, which I really appreciate. I like playing as Maya. Okay. Nine areas, can't go back to the school. Alright, is it worth it for us to, like, try and get Pixie here? Like, reload the save? Or can we find Pixie in the next area? Deja Vusa boy says he got away. Okay, cool. A young man acting older. He ran into me. For some strange reason, I feel I know him from long ago. Alright, so I was right. In one of the earlier casts, I said that I was headcanoning that this green text felt a lot like what Maya kind of, her internal, like, notes on people. Because she's a journalist. She probably keeps tabs on people she knows, information she knows about them. Before, they were always in third person, but now we finally get one in first person. Which is an interesting little change. Anyway, I feel I know him from long ago. He tosses me a disc, it looks like. Alright. Go to a detective's office called Kuzunoha. It's in Aoba. Spread a rumor that you'll be safe with that emblem, even from him. Right, okay, so this is the rumor stuff. It's been established already that rumors seem to be coming true. So I had a vague memory that there was something mechanically with that, that we can, like, spread specific rumors and make things happen plot-wise. So here we're going to make the school a safe zone. Alright, and lastly, do not involve yourself in this. Forget everything. And off he goes. And the police arrive! Detective Tanny. The student profiles aren't reliable, so it looks like another guy has drawn the old maid card. Alright, Cass, we'll see you soon. Alright, so Captain Shimazu says, those two are the first on scene. Where's the student witness? Alright, so Captain Shimazu, he's in charge of the Bizarre Serial Murder Case Division, an elite crime investigative administrator. I was going to do a joke with one of the Law and Order roles. But I've forgotten the words already. I'm a terrible 90s kid. I sent her to the police hospital. The old maid is after the witness. Put some guards on her. So I heard you came in contact with number 501. Report it. Alright guys, let's play Paperwork Simulator. Detective Tanny. Suo, you rest. You've been working too hard since the old maid appeared. Take your dad to a vacation spot once in a while. Mr. Tanny. Alright. Officer Suo, as of today, you are off the team. I heard that you were a superior detective, but it's a shame. What? We're getting railroaded off because we didn't catch this guy? What a farce. I mean, obviously Shimazu is evil. I mean, with character art like that, that's... there's something going on there. Which... I guess that's a little meta, but, you know. Oh, Oh, Morphine 24. That's a good tip. So we don't actually need her if we want to summon her. We can summon her as long as we have a contract with someone in her arcana or tarot cards. That's cool. I think she's not Star. I think she may be Fool, but I'm not certain. Like father, like son. Huh. That's why I tried to stop you. So what are you gonna do? You're not really going on vacation, are you? Oh, I get it. He told them... He must have told them about the demons and monsters and things, and they're just like, this guy needs a break! Don't be absurd. The only officer to see him was me. I will be the one to arrest him. Okay, dude. Dude, you can let go of your pride just a tiny bit. Oh dear. Well then, how about spreading that anti-Joker rumor the Deja Vu boy was talking about? That's absurd. It's not logical. Captain, it's not logical. There are times when rumors do come true, but that's only... Would you stop calling me absurd? Can everything that's happened up to now be explained, you rockhead with sideburns? Sideburns? Fine, whatever. There's the matter of the boy who saved us. Let's hear what the detective has to say. Alright, now we get to walk around. Talking to the detectives is going to advance the plot, so let's talk to these people instead. Noriko! She's back! The latter half of Anna Noriko. OTP. Alright. The principal died. He does! Katsuya goes into battle like, stop! Freeze! It's the police! It's just like, dude, you're dealing with forces beyond the ken of man. You just chill. Put your gun down. Put your badge away. Yeah, he needs a nice tall glass of sake and just to go fishing. You know? Let's see. The principal died, but I know my big sis didn't ask the Joker to. I just know it. Yeah, Anna definitely was not responsible for that. Ms. Smith says, I was just looking for Katayama. Why do the schools I'm at always have these kinds of incidents? I wonder if I'm supposed to know who Katayama is. It's not ringing a bell. But I guess we'll keep that in mind. Let's see, what floor are we even on? Okay, we don't have a map here, so that's interesting. I don't know if I want to save Scum. Boop. Wait for many hilarious dialogues between Katsuya and the new party member. Can't say more because, you know, spoilers. I'm betting it's gonna be, at some point we're gonna meet the conspiracy guy from the opening titles. Mr. Sunglasses at Night. That he just, character design wise, he seems like party member. And if that's true, we're gonna get into some. We're gonna have a good time. We're gonna have a good time. All right, can I go this way? I can. Oh. Well, I did not mean to exit the school. Oops. All right, let's pause for technical difficulties. Reset. Okay. Two seconds. There we go. I do wanna get the dialogue in there, so good thing we dropped a save. Oh man, I'm gonna have to be careful. Some of these things have no warning. I'm an idiot. I am such an idiot. There's a load option in the menu. And I completely forgot. Golden Spider, I have not played Persona 1. I have heard that the North American localization is famously terrible. I've heard nothing but bad things about the North American version. I've also heard that the PSP release fixed some of the issues, but I don't have one. Did we talk to these? Okay. I'll just make sure that we've marked any flags that they might have. But no, I've not played Persona 1. If I understand correctly, it's one of those awkward situations where they took a decidedly Japanese setting and arbitrarily, when they were localizing it, decided that it would be like in Ohio or something like that. Can't go to the party after all. Don't knock it till you try it. Well, I'd like to someday, because I'd like to play the whole series. I have Persona 3 and 4 on the PlayStation 3 release, and I'll probably be visiting those at some point streaming. Not this month, because this month is going to be pretty exclusively Persona 2, because I doubt I'll be able to finish it by the end of the month. But yeah, they're definitely in the queue, and Persona 1, I would like to give a shot. I'd also like to see if there's any completely lost my train of thought there. You can personally say it's all right. It gets annoying, though. That's fair. I mean, as localizations go, like the 90s were a dry time in North America for JRPG fans. I mean, lots of good JRPGs out there, but localizers didn't. Different companies had so many different approaches, and not all of them were terribly good. I'd like to see if there's a fan translation out there of Persona 2 Innocent Sin, which is the companion game or prequel to this game. But that may be something I delve into another time. But yeah, the Persona games are nice. I'd also I have Shin Megami Tensei Nocturne as well, which I've dabbled with. I may stream that at some point. That one seems like it's going to be pretty difficult to stream because it's very grindy. So I might have to come up with a slightly different schedule for something like that. Maybe on off cast days, grind a bit and then advance the story on cast. But we'll see. We'll see. Katsuya, that old maid is not normal, but I'm stuck on what he was saying about the other side and this side. Alright, let's talk to these guys. Suao is a really good cop, but I wonder if he's still angry about his dad. Interesting. There's family history. We know something's up with the Suao family because his brother, who I've forgotten the name of, but his brother goes to this high school and is missing, and apparently has a history of running around being a little rough. Let's talk to him. Shimazu, the first girl to discover. I'll be sending an investigator to get a report. Tell us where we can reach you. Okay. Police, due to the ongoing hearing, soliciting is prohibited. All right there, Mr. Cop Man, with your overcomplicated no comment. That's all right. I'm a journalist. I can take it. I'll get my sources elsewhere. Out we go. Excellent. So now we have our classic SMT overworld map, which I have to say, the first time I played one of these games, it was very refreshing. It's a nice little variation on the classic, like, we're a tiny little sprite of ourselves on a big map, but here it looks a bit more like, it has the look of like MapQuest or something. We're just a little dot moving around. It's very nice. I like it. Alright, we've got lots of choices here. We can go to the shrine. We can talk to... Oh, there's a place to go where we can go to Mount Iwato. We can talk to this person. Let's get the story from the people on the street. The scholar-like man. Onmaru Park is under construction. I heard it's going to take them a while. I miss going there to relax. Very well. And there's the park. This park is under construction. We can't go in there. Which means we'll go there later. It's probably infested with demons. Talk. Housewife. You know that this ward is on the peninsula on Tanaba River, right? Tanabata River, excuse me. In spring, lots of cherry blossoms bloom. They call it the Renegadai because they look like orenge flowers on the water. Nice. Can we go to this person's house? I love the lamp shading from Ulala here. Just like, what? Whose house is this? Is it okay to go inside? No, it is not. Who's this for a thirsty fellow? Boy, did something happen? I saw lots of police cars. I wonder if the Joker got somebody again. All right. Lotus Plaza. Ooh! Okay, here's our shops. Here is our shops. Velvet Room. I know what's gonna happen there. All right. We're gonna exit here for the moment. Let's just check out the shrine. Let's just see what's up here. Another thing I've mentioned on previous casts, that I like and is interesting, is the fact that when you go to rooms and things, your party members are standing around doing their own business. They're not just, like, absorbed into your sprite. It's nice. It works with the rest of the aesthetic of this game, which is very, like, it's like a classic RPG, but it's got this modern sheen or veneer over it. Strips away, it abstracts away a lot of the sort of anachronistic stuff. Katsuya, it's been so long since I've been here. I used to bring my little brother here for the festivals. He's always been so restless. If I look away, next thing you know, he'd be gone. You know, he's still like that. Well, isn't this a rundown shrine? Will the gods make my life miserable for saying that? Well, my life is miserable anyways. It's not that bad. Ooh la la, you hoity-toity person. You, this is nice. It's rustic. Morphine 24. It is a good map theme. You like that Katsuya's persona is a cat. It's appropriate. It's very appropriate. Welcome back, Cass. We've come to a shrine. We managed to get out of the high school. Katsuya has been kicked off the case and told to take a vacation because he's blathering to his superior officers very seriously about demons and monsters and things. And he didn't manage to capture the criminal, so they're just like, dude, take a break. We've come here. Ulala is complaining about the rundown shrine. We're going to talk to the keeper here. I don't think it looks run down. I think it's nice. It's rustic. It's in better condition than a lot of the parks where I live. All we've got is a gazebo, man. This shrine is very old, and nobody knows who built it or when it was built. Maybe the gods themselves did it. We can pray at this shrine. Does not appear that we can do so. Always check the backs of buildings. This is JRPG rule number 2 or 3, probably. I am suspicious. Small lantern, give me your secrets. Okay, you have no secrets. All right. Well, this is nice. Nice little break. Off we go, back to the street. Now, we were told to go and spread rumors. And I'm assuming that the shops are where we want to do that. I wonder if we can go across the bridge. We can. It's interesting that the game is not locking us out of leaving the area. My explorer instincts are tingling and telling me I want to see what's out there, but I feel like we should at least visit every area on this map first. So let's see, we've got a sushi place, we've got someplace called Time Castle, which has a lot of clocks, which is nice. We've got the Velvet Room, which appears to be a nightclub, although we, having meta knowledge of other Persona games, know that this is going to be where we mess around with our personas. We've got a perfume shop named Kaori, and a convenience store. Well, let's just take it from the top. Let's go to Sushi Gatan. Let's get some sushi. Go for some sushi right about now. Be nice. Dig the tunes. Oh, there's fishies! Hello, fishies! Hey, Maya! The one who helped us back at the clock tower was the Deja Vu boy, right? Are you sure you don't remember? Why would someone you just ran into at the station do that? It is very odd. It's very odd. But probably not plot relevant at all. Nope. Not in the least. He said sarcastically. The boy you saw at the clock tower. You say this Deja Vu boy, but who is he? Does he know something about the case? Alright, let's bother these people who are eating. Sushi Nobleman. Oh boy. I'm a member of the Sushi Nobility. The Sushi Nobility, a club for sushi lovers, uses this place to exchange information. To be honest, I love sushi and rumors. Even now, I was asking the Baron of Sushi, Chunky, for a rumor. Okay, so this is where we spread our rumors. This is where we start to make things happen. Now, I'm betting this salary man right here is going to be Chunky. But let's talk to the other patrons first. Duke of Sushi. That guy there all of a sudden became extravagant. He used to always complain that the company president was in his way. Uh-oh. That sounds sinister. Company president. Gah-ha-ha-ha! I've finally become president! I feel so important now, letting the underlings do all the work while I eat. Burn it to the ground. Okay. Let's talk to... Oh, wait, can we talk to our sushi guy here? We can! Konkichi. Hey, Urashai! First-time customers? Thanks for coming! Gaten Sushi is known for the fresh fish and the incredibly low prices. Come eat as much as you want. Let's get an explanation. Let's explain eating. You can eat here. Meals have the effect of increasing a character's ability temporarily. The effect depends on the food, and once you eat, you cannot have another meal until the effect has expired. Golden Spider says, quote, fresh fish. Yes, fresh fish that give us a special effect. The special effect is botulism. That's our status effect. But no, I really dig this mechanically. A lot of the things that you'd expect from a normal RPG, you know, buffs and so forth, are abstracted here, not as items so much in your inventory or potions and things like that, but things that would take that place are like going out and having a meal or having a drink or going to a perfume shop, which is really rad. Like, I like that. I like that a lot. There had clearly been a lot of care taken into making and designing this game. Let's talk to the guy. I moved here just recently, but I used to have this shop in Hirosaka. Why'd I move, you ask?
It's the fortune telling. I was told that I'll do good business if I opened my shop here. I had to move here. Okay, so we come back to the fortune tellings and the Wang Long fortunes, which have been coming true, which intuition suggests is related to rumors and things coming true. Select a member that will eat. Let's just see what. Oh, interesting. So these are all mysteries. We won't know what any of these do until we try them. Well, that's fun. I don't think we're gonna do that right away. Let's see if we can advance the plot a little more. But we'll come back here. We will come back here. What is the difference between quit and exit? Yeah, come back while our fish is fresh. You're always welcome. Matakita ne. It's very odd that they have two options for quitting and exiting. Rumormonger Chunky. Well, I'm a really good salesman, but I've become friendly with rumors. Now they call me a rumormonger. Kenta Yokuchi, a graduate of St. Hermelin Academy, a successful salesman who knows a lot about rumors. His persona seems to have helped his career. So St. Hermelin has come up before. The principal of Seven Sisters was formerly the principal of St. Hermelin. And I'm not sure. I think Maya either went to Seven Sisters or St. Hermelin. I think we got at least that much backstory, but I don't recall which. But she definitely went to one of the two. Rumors come in handy for sales. So if you hear a good rumor, come tell me. I'll tell you one of mine in return. Sweet. Let's hear some rumors. Sorry, I haven't gotten anything new yet. Could you come back later? Interesting. Alright, well, we gotta spread our rumor to this guy to make the Seven Sisters Academy safe. So let's go ahead and talk to him. Not only am I a rumor monger, I am the Baron of Sushi, a member of the Sushi nobility. Do you want to join? So can we not spread the rumor? Apparently not yet. That's interesting. Okay, well, return if you want to hear a rumor. I'll be sitting here eating fish fin. Do I have to do something with this item? We have a good luck bunny. We've got our cellular phone, which features a daily Wang Long fortune, which we might want to check. This is our murder note from the Joker. This is the emblem. Seven Sisters High School emblem given by the Deja Vu Boy. Does it really offer protection from the Joker? Clock Tower Key. We've got our good luck bunny. Okay, and we can't actually use any of these. Okay. Now you can spread rumors in Aoba, a detective office. Oh, okay. Thank you, Morphine24, that's very helpful. So the rumor mongers only give you the rumors, and then you can spread them in the office. Fantastic. Well, let's visit the other shops. See what we've got going on here. Let's see what's up with the Time Castle. I do like this overworld music. This is really nice. Do, 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 do.
Oh, nice. Smooth jazz. This is a cool place to hang out. All these clocks. Legit, this is a place that I would love to hang out. Oh! Hello, conspicuous anime man. We're gonna talk to you last. Quiet gentleman. This is an antique shop, but what they actually have are just clocks. Well, that's what I like about it anyway. This is a collector's dream. You, madam. Middle-aged lady. Hey, you know, do you know the Joker curse? You see, if you call your own cell phone... No, never mind. Alright, so this is not just something that high schoolers are talking about now. This is something that's at large in the general populace. See something you like, Ulala? Nothing good ever happens when I'm with you. What you gonna do about my party? Well, not that it's really your fault. Jeez. Sorry to have ruined your day, Ulala. Katsuya, what do you have to say? Sayako Smith, was it? Finding a hot-blooded teacher is rare these days. Very impressive indeed. Come on! Katsuya, you're investigating her school! Keep it in your pants. Compare that to Tetsuya. Why did he turn out the way that way while having a teacher like that? I just can't understand him. You got some family issues, dude. Just saying. Alright, let's talk to Conspicuous Anime Man. Also, this is a rad clock. I want this clock. Okay. Well, hello. The Count. I see. Not accepting fate, you have turned back the wheels of time. Humans are, veritably, pitiful beings. But it seems there are no roles left for me to play. I would like to have my reason for my existence determined already. Wouldn't we all? That guy reminds me a little bit of one of the characters from... I forget the name. I watched someone playing it. It's a... Digital Devil Survivor, I think. Digital Devil Survivor 2, maybe? But yes, he seems very much like the star guy in that game. So my working assumption is he's important. Okay, let's check out the rest of this mall. Let's go to Kaori. Nice. God, it must smell amazing in this place. Look at all this stuff. In case you forgot, I'm just a regular normal citizen, you know? I'm feeling down with all these murders. So I want to calm myself down with some aromatherapy. Breathe in, breathe out. You got the right idea, Ulala. Let's all just take a... We'll do some self-care. That's what we need. Just light some candles, incense. The aromatherapy here can even cure wounds and illnesses. I didn't believe the rumor, but it was true. Okay, so now we have our gameplay reason for this shop existing. So this is the healing stuff.
I never thought I would have to depend on this kind of thing, but it's helping now. Personas, Philemon, all these insane things are happening. Tell you the truth, it makes my head spin. Young guy. Kaori's husband died 5 years ago. She's been keeping this shop open all by herself since then. Kaori, welcome to my shop. What scent are you looking for today? Oh, sweet. We'll put the explanation up. Can be treated for recovery here. HP and SP will be recovered, and all status ailments will be cured. Sweet. So, lesson learned. Flower shops. That's our hospital. That is our Poke hospital. We don't really need it, but okay. And she says you all seem very healthy. We do not need treatment. Is there anything else you would like? Please do not hesitate to tell me. Let's just talk. Scents have different effects. Not only do they soothe the soul, but they can also help illnesses. Excellent. And again, we've got quit and exit. If we hit exit, she says, please come again. And we go straight out the shop. Okay, so that's to save a few seconds of time. Do let me know if this is boring to you all who've seen the game before or first-time watchers. I'm going through checking things out for talking about stuff, but we can easily skip right past this if this is not your jam. Do free to let me know in the chat. Oh boy. Every day's great at your Judeness. Oh my god. There are actual lyrics. This makes me so happy. Okay. Alright. My daughter goes to Seven Sisters, came home looking all pale. I wonder if something happened at school. I don't know, man. Maybe ask her? Do you not talk to your kids? No, not Juness. The Joker incident's only gotten that name recently. In the beginning, it was just a serial killing. Since the Joker curse got popular while the killer hasn't been caught, a rumor saying the Joker did it was started. We did it! We created the monster! People and their rumors! This is all just a moral play about not spreading rumors. That man who killed the principal, did he commit the serial murders? No, it's too early to decide that. I don't know, man. The serial killing started about 6 months ago, before the fortune-telling craze began, before the Joker curse. Interesting. Interesting. Let's see. From now on, pale skin is in. I wonder if it'll really help me get my ideal boyfriend. You know what, Ulala? You're fine the way you are, you know? But that said, what you want to do is up to you. But as your friend, body positivity, we are, you don't need to change for anyone. Let's see. Okay, so we've got our things. Can't actually interact with anything but the shopkeeper. Satomi sister number 6. Hello and nice to meet you. I'm the 6th sister of the 7 Satomi sisters. Buy your items here. How much do we want to bet they're septuplets? They're just all the same sprite. Let's see. Let's talk. Even if they're all my relatives, they're all competition. That's how the Satomis are raised. Down with the eldest. Okay, I like this person. I'm picking up what you're putting down. Okay. Item. Oh, okay. So this is how we can sell stuff. I don't think I actually want to do that. Let me just make sure. Yeah, no, this is just... You can use items that you have at the time. Okay. Cool. What have you got to buy? What are you buying? Okay, Gala Gala drink. That restores characters' HP by 200. Restores characters' HP fully. Restores an character's SP by 30. Okay, we might want to pick some of that up. Ball of Returning. Recovers an unconscious character, restoring some HP. Okay, we definitely want at least three of those. I mean, we're probably going to find some in dungeons and things, but my general rule of thumb is get at least enough revive items to revive each member of your party once. Let's see, Lucky Bag. Item recovers a possessed character. We can get magazines about equipment. And about spells. And about interesting items. I mean, do we pick these up? Do they give us access to spells that we don't know about yet? That's very interesting, though. I dig when games do stuff like this, where they just like, here, have a magazine about stuff. Okay, we're gonna buy... Can I not? Ah! That's what this is. Okay. You know what? We're just gonna get one for now. And we're gonna add... This is... Okay. That's probably good for now. I'd say. We'll go ahead and pick up more snuff souls because we're mostly going to be using Maya to heal, I think, rather than items. Let's splurge. We'll get four of these. Five. No. Don't buy the magazines? Okay. Alright, that's good advice. Alright. That's good. We'll get some items. Okay. I'm gonna be a little stingy at first, just because... I don't know what we're gonna come up against. And we can't go to the Velvet Room yet. Alright, so now we need to find Aoba. Let's go this way! This is a very peculiarly shaped city. Do you remember how folks were saying that they discovered something underground when they were... doing some sort of construction on one of the subway stations?
And the whole city is shaped like this big circular symbol. That's suspicious. That's very suspicious. All right, let's go to Aoba. Whee! Okay, so this is Aoba Drive. Aha! All right, so these are more shops. We'll talk to the people on the street first. Middle-aged businessman. Another Joker incident. It sure is an unpleasant world. Compared to what happened earlier, the incidents have become more complex and cruel. It's as if the killer is changing. Yeah, they do that. They do that. This is the Kismet Pub. Oh, that's where we work. This is our publishing house. Walking Woman. The more recent incidents with the Joker have become more violent than before. The killer must be a psychopath. Well, there, armchair psychology here. There's no good or bad in murder, but it's been getting worse ever since the media got involved. In Innocent Sin was the conspiracy about the city shape. Okay, alright. I'm just saying, it's very suspicious looking. And the one guy at the school, I'm calling him Fox Mulder because he thinks it's a UFO, which I like. I appreciate that. But also, this woman is like, there's no good or bad in murder. It's like, I think it's pretty bad, generally speaking. I'm not down with murder. Just saying. Let's talk to you, young man. I just moved here, but Aoba sure is a great place. It's very peaceful and relaxing. Also, I'll be well informed by having Kismet Publications and Sumeru TV around. There's even an outdoor music bowl, so I'll see some celebrities when I go shopping. Now, if only if the rent was cheaper. Thank you, gentrification. Thank you. Aoba Park. It's all right to relax in a park, but I don't think now is the time. Willala, keeping us on the straight and narrow. Alright, what else can we see here? Follow the light. Sumeru TV. We can't just go snooping around the TV station. They won't let us any further than the reception area. That's what you think, Katsuya. But I am the protagonist. We have a way around these things. Alright, Kismet Pub. We'll go see what we can do here. Police work is an occupation where you come across a lot of shady characters. I've actually gotten used to it. You seem so disappointed. Not the thrill it used to be, huh? Alright. Giggle. That officer said shady. Was that a joke or was he serious? Receptionist. Hey, Maya. Didn't you go to cover 7th High? There was a murder there, wasn't there? No way. You saw a dead body? Then you were questioned by the police and stuff? That's an officer right there? This has gotten pretty big, hasn't it? No kidding! People are dying! I'd say that's pretty big. I don't know what business we have investigating in the first place. We're a teen magazine. I mean, it's probably good for my career, getting in on a story this big, but just saying. Alright, do we go emergency exit? Cannot go there. Let's go up to our office floor. See if there's anything else shaken. You, sir. Cub reporter. Miss Amano, I heard you got mixed up in the incident while gathering news, but are you alright? Whew. Without you, I don't think I can go on with this job.
they're finding some more ruins all over the world, just like the subway construction site. Is that just pure coincidence? Sure, buddy. Absolutely, don't you worry about it. Everything is A-okay. There's no veil to be pulled back of this masquerade. Ha! That would be silly. Okay, reporter. Did you know? Serial killing is something that middle to upper class people do in developed nations. Statistics say so. Well, no shit, because they have the time. Let's see. All I get are letters and calls of complaints. Am I customer service here? Whoops, I gotta deal with them. Ms. Amano, welcome back. I heard you were mixed up with the incident. Wasn't it an important experience as an editor? Good for you. Very helpful. Very supportive. But yeah, I almost died. Good for you! Great job! Sigh. Wang Long, Wang Long, Wang Long! I'm so busy with the Wang Long craze. Why am I in charge of fortunes, you say? A person of the Gold Dragon takes on anything! Hey, it started from Wang Long fortune-telling. Oh dear. Alright, let's talk to our boss. She's probably gonna yell at us again. Bum 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 ba doo 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 doo. What happened to the coverage on 7th High? Give me an update. What? You met the Joker? Persona? Demon? What are you daydreaming for? Go get coverage. Call it like I see it, man. Sales numbers are dropping. That's why the chief is angry. All right. Well, nothing too important is happening here. We'll talk to our friend the photographer. Yuki. Ah, Maya. You got mixed up in that 7th incident, right? Is Myth Smith okay? See, that's good. Really, I'm relieved. Yuki, we know for certain, used to go to Seven Sisters, but she was pulled off the case, so that we could go there because our boss was upset at us for writing about our deja vu boy. Oh, welcome back, Mackie. That was bad timing getting caught up in that incident, but it'll make for good copy. Spoken like a true journalist. Good luck writing a good article. Thank you. It will be good. I mean, it's gonna read like Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas, but it'll be a good article. Okay, let's get out of here. Okay. We'll go to our... We'll accomplish this this quest, and then we'll start wrapping it up here, I think. Streaming schedule this week. I think we're gonna try for Monday, Wednesday, Friday. At around the same time. Okay. So here we are at one of the Lucky Cat places. Tammy. Welcome! We take cases of all kinds, from secret love affairs to ghosts. While going to college, she works as a devil summoner. That's a curious occupation. Well, no, I want to ask something. Do, 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 do. Chief Todoroki, I've never taken a request to spread rumors, but someone did come in to ask if the Joker rumor was spread. How curious. Todoroki. He used to be a flunky, but all of a sudden he got smart. Now, he works as a devil summoner. Interesting. What kind of person was he? That's the Deja Vu boy. Maya says so too. Tell me a little more. I don't know what you're talking about. I see. Very interesting. The bizarre serial murders, the rumors of the Joker, the sighting of demons. It all makes sense if the rumors are true. I'll accept the request to spread that anti-Joker rumor. It's a good chance to see if a rumor can become a reality. I don't know why we can't just spread a rumor that the Joker isn't real. I mean, I suppose it's one of those things where once something has gotten ingrained enough in people that it's not gonna go away. But that also means that this is a world where Bigfoot probably exists. Let's see, you seem to have accepted that quickly. You're not gonna report it to the hospital? The world is filled with mystery. We can't be held down by common sense. Well then, a real man goes by his own rules. First, ask me to spread the rumor. Telling us to spread rumors means the boy must believe it too. Who is he? Ask him, Maya. You've got nothing to lose. Nothing to lose except this lucky cat! Adults insert 1,000 meow. Please insert 1,000 yen. Sure. Thank you. Meow. Tammy, don't ask me for a job, ask the chief. Chief Todoroki, everything has to be settled. That will never change. Remember the procedure. Spreading rumors. You can spread rumors through the city. You can get info on rumors through rumor mongers and messengers. Oh. No, no, no. Clicked the button too fast. Power that the emblem holds. Ah, see? I thought I heard something about this. So we can, presumably, as the game goes on, we will get more rumors and types of rumors to spread, and we have a certain amount of granularity in terms of how they're actually implemented. So here we're going to pick that the power that the emblem holds repels the Joker. This is kind of like Mad Libs, except for rumors. Very good. Pretty good. Chief Todoroki, anything else? Talk. Merely fighting demons isn't skill. Try negotiating with them. How do I know this stuff? I look like this, but I do work in a demon-related business. The request is now approved. Check the results yourself. If you have any other rumors to spread, get information from the rumor mongers. They're everywhere. That Deja Vu boy seems to be looking for the source of the rumors. I know of a good underground page. Oh, sweet! We're gonna get underground zines, too. Bao Fu, who's a friend of the chief, has a webpage with all the rumors in this city. He's in a chat room right now. Maybe even this one. Ooh. Bao Fu, Rabbit, you saw the Joker? They say no one escapes once he's after you. How'd you survive? So, you're saying I wouldn't believe it? Oh, well, I know when I see you.
See, what does that low-res texture actually say?
Baofu, dark side of Sumeru City. www.baofu.com/.htm. We'll meet at 2x/ in Aoba, Rabbit. Tell the worker my handle and do what they tell you.
Ooh, intrigue.
Sounds suspicious. Should we go?
Hell yeah! My weekend's not getting any more interesting.
All right. Okay, we can't interact with that again. And what's in this back room here? Some washing up. Little kitchenette. What's this? Lucky cat. That probably won't open. Meow. Okay. Inference. We give the lucky cat enough money. Something good is behind this door, and it opens. But we're not going to waste any more money just now. It's over here. Nothing. Stone nothing. That is a very large set of speakers. Holy cow, I just noticed those. Those are bigger than I am. Is he having concerts in here? Good God. Like, this is probably on the upper floor of, like, a multi-story building. Goodness gracious. Okay. So, let's see, we've got our convenience store. Etheria looks like it's maybe one of the, the healing places. 2x/ is food. Parabellum is food. Okay, Rosa Canada is Rosa Candida, excuse me. Not Canada. Is armor. Let's check that out. I just want to see if we've got good armor we can get yet before we finish this quest. Again, really nice tunes. Sales lady. Sales lady who cannot see through her hair. Oh, welcome. What do you think? They're all beautiful clothes, aren't they? Please, don't hesitate to buy anything. Right, what are you selling? Casual shirt and silver dress. Defense 2 and luck plus 1, female only. Sweet. But pretty much identical defense-wise in terms of what we have right now. So probably not worth our money just at the moment. Unless we were, like, pumping luck, which we're not. Once you see our products, you'll never be able to shop anywhere else. Please come back again. I don't know why I decided to make her sinister. It just seemed appropriate. That said, this seems like a nice shop. Wait for rumors about armor in her shop. I thought it might be something like that. A woman. What? Is something wrong with me wearing woman's clothing? I'm a woman! W-O-M-A-N. Male otherwise, but my heart is female. That's cool. You go, girl. Alright. Hey, that's the dressing room. Don't go in there without a reason.
Interesting. Cool. So let's see. See, Maya, they have lots of cool clothes. As a magazine editor, you should wear nicer clothes than just the ones I pick. Here, how about this one? I love it. We get to go shopping. That's exciting. All right. These are some pretty rough-looking clothes. This is what's popular now? I don't get it. Am I getting old? Yes, Katsuya, you are ancient, and you aren't cool anymore. Deal with it. All right. Although your sideburns are rad, I will give you that. Okay. I believe Parabellum is where we want to go. We can check for rumors in here, but I doubt there'll be anything. Boom boom boom. Dum ba dum ba dum boom 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 boom. Oh, I guess this is where we were supposed to go. For some reason, I thought we were supposed to go to Parabellum. Unmotivated waiter. Welcome, Rabbit. Yes, I've heard. Use that red machine over there. What, you mean the old iPad? Or iPad. iMac. We had these in school. These were all of our school computers. We had these colors too. SimCity 2000. Right. Let's get on with this chat here. Rabbit, I see how you've survived. I didn't imagine 3 Persona users. What? How'd you know that? There we have 30 Seconds to Mars starting up in the background again. This is a persona? Oh, hey! It's Sunglasses Man! Baofu. You people have just become Persona users. You don't know how to use your chi. It's obvious. He is a tap buster and has a webpage that collects all the city's rumors. He says he's from Taiwan. I like this guy already. Seems cool. We've got some international intrigue here. Just from him being from Taiwan and in Japan. Highly suggests something's odd, especially the fact that she would note that. And him being a tap buster suggests some involvement in the intelligence community. So that's interesting. Hey, no smoking indoors, man! Baofu says, follow me. Okay, so when you said you would be given instructions, you just meant, I will come and fetch you. All right. Conversation. Boom, 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 boom. What is a man? I see. Interesting. We said about all we know. Now it's your turn. From what I've researched, the Joker rumors are taken from some TV show, which then start to spread like wildfire. But before that, not even the J in Joker was known to the public. There's just one exception. Where do you think it is? The phone? Of Tatsuzo Sudao. That's our policeman's brother.
Who is Tatsuzo Sudao? The current foreign minister. Oh, okay, so it's not our brother. Maybe it's our father. The current foreign minister. How would you know? A wiretap? That's illegal. Dude, that's not gonna stop him. Don't be so stiff. It's been going around that he's been doing some pretty dirty stuff underground. Like digging in dirt and mud and sewage. It's very gross, not hygienic. You should have him check into a hospital. That 10-year unsolved serial arson murder case. It's an infamous rumor between police and investigators that it was his son. Is that true? What, you don't know? Well, either way, about this incident, you don't think it was a coincidence? Katsuya is Suo, not Sudo. Oh, thank you very much, Morphine24. I completely did not notice that. I feel a little like a jerk. Thank you. I'm sure if it was pronounced, there would be a lot more of a noticeable difference. But transliterated. Oops. Okay. Well, Baofu says, you don't think it was a coincidence, do you? Then the foreign minister Tatsuzo Sudo has something to do with the Joker case? Yes, that's what we've just been saying. We are going to find out about that now. Take me with you. I know where Sudo's son lives. Yay, fourth party member! Excellent. You guys get clues on the Joker. As long as I'm by the next target, I will get closer to the truth. Not a bad deal. What do you plan to do with the truth? Your objective is blackmail, huh? My intentions are honorable, I can assure you. I can't let evil prevail. What should we do? You're being targeted, you decide. Well, obviously we take this guy on. Shady though he may be. You understand what I'm talking about. Well then, let me test something first. Let me take out my brick cell phone here. Yeah, Todoroki? I'm in Parabellum right now. Spread a rumor that they're selling weapons here. Excellent. Hey, what are you trying to do? I don't believe that rumors can come true, so I'm testing it out. Very good. That is quite good. The scientific approach. Ha! I'm surprised. Hell, it actually worked. We have other weapons lined up. Please, feel free to ask for anything. Really, really digging the film noir feel of this bar. It's great. Then, does that mean that the rumor about the emblem is now true? Then, you're all right, Maya. So what you gonna do with the emblem? If you keep it, the Joker will just stay away. You don't think you'll run into the deja vu brat anymore? Think of why he gave you that.
anime cutscene! Very nice. That is classy. We're a risk taker. We'll get to the truth. Baofu. Sudo's son should be at the sanitarium at Mount Mifune. I see. Miss Amano, let's check it out. Hold on. There's a place called the Velvet Room around here. It has something to do with demons. Considering the situation you're in right now, you'll need all the help you can get. Let's go in and have a look. What is that? What does that have to do with anything? I don't even feel like explaining. Just follow me. Sweet. Well, let's go to the Velvet Room and then we'll call it a night. Not a lot of action and battles this time around, but we made a lot of progress story-wise. Yay! Good music. And wow, you have a very pronounced... You know what? You do you, man. You rock that look. Igor, welcome to the Velvet Room. This is where different forms of people's hearts are called to awaken. By order of our master Philemon, we have been awaiting you. My name is Igor. I am Belladonna. I sing for those who challenge the monster known as oneself. I am Nameless, the piano player who opens the closed doors of the heart. You also look like Antonio Banderas. Just putting that out there. Which is fine. Like, it's just noticing. Demon artist. I am the demon artist. I am the artist who draws the gods and demons that dwell within people. Sweet. This is a nice little happening bohemian kind of place. I'd totally hang out here. We are told to assist the awakening of your new hearts, your new personas. I am very glad to make your acquaintance. Sweet. A gentleman who came here long ago said he will shed his tears because he has lost what he should not have. I pray that you will not have to shed tears in such a way. Can I just say, again, this is probably the third or fourth time I've said this, but the character design in these games is really strong. The you that I know and the you that you know, are these two the same? If they are different, then it means there are millions upon millions of you in the world. Right now, you are just one of many. Okay. Demon artist. Tarot cards are models of the heart. The heart controls a person's fate. Do you want me to paint something?
What,
Which explanation will you read? Let's see. Request. You can request the demon artist to make a tarot card. However, each request consumes one free tarot. Interesting. So, we have a free tarot card. But apparently we can get more. And we haven't encountered any demons that give us free tarot yet. So that must be something we get, like, in... either in demons we haven't encountered yet, or in, story sequences. Free tarot. A free tarot is a blank card. If you request it from the demon artist, you can return it into whatever tarot card you want. Also, the demon artist can create cards that you cannot obtain from negotiating with demons. Obtaining. To obtain free tarot cards, you must first make a contract with a demon. Oh, I see! Okay, so that's how we got them, because when we talked with Ghost, after we contracted them, they gave us a free tarot card. I assumed that meant that they just gave us extras of the ones that they were already giving us. But it's actually a separate... That's rad! Okay. You then negotiate again with the demon you contracted, and if they get your interest to max, they'll give you some. Like other tarot cards, the amount of free cards they give you varies from demon to demon. So, for example, if you need 40 hangman cards for summon a persona, you can make them from 40 free cards. You can use them for all arcanas. That's why they're awesome. Cool! That's really rad. Alright. What can we do here? Cool. Alright. So, we can get all the different arcana, even ones that we haven't encountered yet. That's awesome. Cool. Alright, what do you have to say for yourself? I sometimes wonder if there is only one reality, the world as we know it, or if there are more. Why, maybe even somewhere out there, someone is looking down at us, playing us like a game. Okay. Just a bit of fun there. Alright. I will always be here. Come back whenever you feel like it. Here, time does not mean anything. Oh, I didn't mean to leave. No, go back. I want to hear what the other people have to say. You're playing a different song. That's cool. So, what do you think? Useful, huh? Listen, personas are just tools. Use them according to the situation. Don't ever think that's you. I'd never admit that's me. You can only account on yourself in the end. Some existential conflicts here. I wonder what his persona is. Followers of Philemon? Then that was not a dream at all. I dreamt about this as a kid. A golden butterfly. Masked man. Blue room. The night I played Persona with Tatsuya. Eh? I mean, he must mean some sort of in-universe, child's game, but that'd be a really cool bit of fourth wall breaking if he meant, like, the first Persona game on their PlayStation. Good old Beethoven. Okay. We're not going to break into Trans-Siberian Orchestra here, even though
I have a sudden, strong, irrational urge to do so. Ooh la la. So, in other words, you can have all sorts of personas summoned here? That's pretty convenient. Come to think of it, back in high school I learned Persona from you and played it. I wonder if it has anything to do with this. Fascinating. Okay, so you must be who we talk to summon things. What business do you have today? Okay, alright. Well, let's have an explanation here. Let's read about cards. Pick a card. Right, tarot card. In order to summon personas, you must have these cards. You can obtain them by negotiating with demons. But even if you have the cards, you cannot summon a persona who is 5 levels higher than the highest level in your party. Good to know. So we can't cheese our way to extremely high level demons. Persona growth. Activated personas can rank up to increase their abilities. Each time you invoke a persona, it gains experience. When it gains a certain amount of experience, it goes up in rank. When a persona goes up in rank, it not only raises its skill parameters, but it may also learn new spells. There are 8 ranks in all, and the amount of experience required for the next rank up varies from persona to persona. But a rank increase does not affect how much SP is required to invoke a persona. Cool. So our personas get stronger, but we don't necessarily have to spend more SP to use their special attacks and things. So that's good to know. Let's see. Activate and invoke. You can activate personas within the persona user's body. After doing this, you can then invoke the persona. Invoking a persona calls out a persona and unleashes its abilities. Activating a persona can affect the persona user's own status as well. You can't activate more than one persona for each person, but you can trade personas at any time using persona cards. Interesting. So I could, in theory, like, swap Helios to Maya if for some reason I wanted to do that. I don't know if there's any advantage to doing that just yet. But apparently we can. So that's a thing. Persona compatibility. Personas and characters each have varied levels of compatibility with one another. If both are not compatible, it may require more SP to invoke it. In certain cases, you won't even be able to activate a persona. But if they are compatible, less SP will be required to invoke. If compatibility is high, personas may even gain new powers. Cool. More cards. Persona cards. A summoned persona. When not activated, it rests in the form of a card. Material card. These cards are necessary to summon special persona. When you have a material card, personas which correspond to that card are shown in blue on the summon list. Okay, so Helios is synchronized to Katsuya, and same with Maya and Callisto, but anything summoned from the Velvet Room, of course. Okay, cool beans. I figured it might be something like that, but, that makes sense. Let's see. Incense. Summoning cards raises the persona's abilities. It cannot be used on personas that are already summoned. Okay. Interesting. So there's lots of granularity here. Cards when summoning and have a persona remember new spells. Oh! You can only use one card per summoning.
There is compatibility between personas and spell cards. You cannot use a card that is not compatible with the personas. Interesting. Okay, so these are like, if we reach a little for the Pokemon metaphor or analogy, these are TMs or HMs. But maybe only usable once? Cool. Oh, no, didn't want the... right, let's talk once more. It's not always the case. All personas can be called if you just collect tarot cards. There are certain conditions for some. Some of them lie deep within the subconscious, and some kind of trigger is needed to summon these. The material card is what becomes that trigger. Very cool. Alright, let's see if we can summon anybody. Whoa. We can summon a level 16 Tengu. A Tensen Nyan Nyan. It sounds like a kitty. It is not a kitty. Whew. It's got lots of needles and things. That's cool. And it reflects some, Okay. Alright, cool. So we've got a whole bunch of different ones. Okay, and here we can summon Pixie as a persona. Cool. And since we've got Poltergeist, someone in our Poltergeist Arcana, we can, or in the Devil Arcana, we can summon Poltergeist. Sweet. He's got Magna, Posmoody, Sonic Punch, Illuzone, and Gry. Interesting. These are spells cost less AP when Maya's using them. Yeah. Cool. Magician, Moon, and Hermit Arcana. Okay, so if we can get Squirrel Girl, that'll be a persona we can use with Maya. That's fun. Okay. Well, we are going to exit. And we are actually going to draw the stream to a close here. It went a little bit over time. This is fun. I'm excited. We're gonna get into the nitty gritty. We're gonna try and maybe upgrade our equipment next time, call some, new personas. And we're gonna proceed to the next area. So yeah, that's what's in store. Let's see, how do I have to be in an area to save? Alright, we'll go to Parabellum and we'll save there. Sweet. Well, that's it for the stream tonight. Thank you all for coming. Thank you, new viewers, for coming in. Feel free to follow me on social media. I'm gonna put that link in the chat here. I am on Twitter and at, let's see, p://twitter.com/the_drift. And I am also on Tumblr, and I have, you can find my art
I am an illustrator, sort of part-time amateur, but I do take commissions. You can find all that information under my art tag and commissions tag, which I will put in the chat as well. That's cutespaceships.tumblr.com, and with the tags my art and commissions there. Thank you all for coming out. Feel free to give a follow on this channel if you want updates as to when I'm going live, or follow me on Twitter or on Tumblr. We'll see you all back here at some point. Hope you enjoyed the stream. It was a lot of fun for me. Cheers, all.